Luck may soon run out for the Seminole tribe. They are hoping to keep exclusive rights to blackjack and other card games with the state of Florida. NBC2's Chris Gilmore looked into the uncertain future of gambling in Southwest Florida.
It's got the best odds in the casino from everything that I've heard.
Estero resident Roger Randolph likes to play blackjack, but he's hearing the odds blackjack is here to stay at Seminole Casino Immokalee is uncertain. A five-year deal between the state and Seminole Tribe is set to expire on Friday.
The Seminole casinos have had exclusive rights to the blackjack game over the past 5 years, but after this Friday, they'll have 90 days before they need to completely clear out their tables.
But tribe leaders say they deserve an extension on the agreement because the state didn't keep up their end of the deal. Electronic blackjack games are inside places like dog tracks.
By allowing casinos in South Florida to offer electronic blackjack, electronic table games, which is essentially the tribe contends a violation of the compact.
Gary Bittner says the tribe is optimistic for a new deal. A proposal for a year extension already failed in the state legislature. The state could let private companies build their own casinos.
It's lucrative. It's good tax income for them. So, and like I said, people are going to gamble.
Bittner says the Seminole Tribe has been paying the state $250 million a year for exclusive gambling rights.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I understand. It's money.
It's a lot of money, too.
It's a lot of money, yeah.
Making losing blackjack a risky business. In Immokalee, Chris Gilmore, NBC2.